Hello friends, first of all let me tell you sorry that I was not able to upload videos for a long time now. Mainly it was because of my work commitments and some personal commitments, and also I was thinking how to present this DC machines as a good package to all of you people there. The main problem with DC machines is that I was confused whether I should take the DC generator initially completely and then start with the DC motors. But then I thought, since we have discussed with the commutators in DC generators, if I don't tell the working of the DC motor at this point of time, you might not be able to understand the beauty of the commutator or the concepts which explain the commutator properly. So therefore, I thought that once we have concluded in the last session with the DC generators, basic working, I am again telling you the construction we have not discussed. We are just going with the single loop type. So in this lecture session, we will be starting with the basic working of the DC motor. Okay, so like in the DC generator case, in this case also we will not be getting the DC motor. The DC motor actual working will come in the next lecture. But however, this lecture is intended to give a proper motivation towards the commutator, which is going to come into play in the next session. All right. So before this, what you have to understand here is that
magnetic field experiences a force,
right? And that force is called the Lorentz force. I'll just write it down here. It is called the Lorentz force. Okay, so you have a conductor, and when you place it in a magnetic field, it experiences a force. All right, the basic physics you might already seen in your 12th class or something like that. I will not explain that. So what is the direction of the force? The direction of force is the direction of I cross B. In the same way, the direction of the induced EMF in DC generators was the direction of the V cross B. In this case, direction of force will be the direction of I cross B. And I have already explained how to find the direction of I cross B. So in this session also, let us start with the slip ring structure here, because I told that this will not give you the working of the DC motor. This is just going to be the motivation to the commutator that will be used. So I'll just eliminate this here. Okay, so I am having a battery here now. So let me have V volts, and it is driving a current I like this. So current A, conductor AB is getting a current like this, because the current path is like that. And conductor CD is getting a current path like this. So now let us find what is the force which is experienced here. So this is north and this is south here. So this is my conductor AB and this is my conductor CD. All right. So this is an inward going current, right? So you have a cross, and this is an outward coming current, so you have a dot. So this is the direction of currents, all right, cross and dot. Now what is the direction of field? The direction of field is always this direction. So for this, the direction of field will be like this, and for this, the direction of field will be like this. So let's first find what is the direction of force in the conductor AB. So now clearly, because the field is having this direction, all right, so I cross B means you cross I, which is going into this thing towards here. Therefore, now in this case, you will have a clockwise rotation and you will have a downwards force. Okay, so visualize like this. The current is going into the paper and the field is moving from left to right. Therefore, if I put it in the cuboid like I used to put, so something like this if I draw, okay, so just rub that, I'll draw it here. Okay, so it's something like this. This is the direction of current and this is the direction of field. So the force will be in this axis, perpendicular to both I and perpendicular to both I and B. So I cross B, you take I and cross it with B, therefore you have a clockwise rotation, the screw goes downwards. So this will be the force direction. So the conductor AB, the force will be in this direction. In the same way, this is coming outwards, and the field is in this direction. And therefore, if you take I cross B here, take I and cross with B, here you will get an upward force. So here you are getting an upward force. So force is like this. That means, if I to show it, let me just take my power bank here. So I hope you people will be able to see this. So if this direction, this is the AB conductor, and this is the CD conductor, and the current through AB is going coming towards you, that is into, and the current to CD is coming outwards, it is coming towards me. So what I am telling is that the field is in this direction, the current is in this direction, so take I and cross it with B, the field is in this direction, remember, so cross it with B, you are a downward, and here you are going upward. So what will happen, if this is the conductor A, this is the conductor B, it will start rotating like this, and it will come to a new position. All right, it is going to come to a new position. So that is what I have shown in the second place here. But you remember that AB, because it's a slip ring, is always connected to brush B1. See, I have written here also, AB is always connected to B1, and CD is always connected to B2. So therefore, the current here, like this, it will come here, like this, like this, like this, it will come here, it will come here, it will come here, and it will come here. So let us just see what will be the direction of force now. It will be an interesting conclusion. So this is CD, and this is AB. The current direction here, it's still inwards. See, here also it was inwards. First case also it was inwards. Second case is also inwards. So like this. So now field is in this direction. Field is in this direction. Now, I don't have to do the analysis once again. I know that when the current is inward direction and the field is from left to right, the force will be in the downward direction. And here, the force will be in the upward direction. Now, friends, let us see what has happened here. In the diagram, it might not be very clear, but let me show it theoretically what happens. Now, I have shown this power bank once again. See, this is the conductor AB, and this is the conductor CD in the first case, right? So here it had a downward force and here it had an upward force, okay? Now, because of that, it is going to rotate like this, and it comes to the south pole, which is here now. Here again, the current is in the same direction and the field is in this direction. So again, the force will be downwards in the AB conductor. So from here, it will experience again the downward force. It will come back here. It will come here. Again, it will experience downward force, and this will happen. The motor is not going to rotate. So what is happening here? What is happening here is that the slip ring is always providing the same direction of current to the conductor AB and CD. So AB, it is always inward, and CD, it is always outward. Therefore, the force will be always having the same direction. Therefore, initially, even though it is able to rotate, but when it comes to the next pole, it gets the same direction of force. At that point, actually, the current should reverse so that the force is in the opposite direction. Okay, so what should actually happen is that this is the AB conductor and this is the CD conductor. It should start from this point. It should come like this, should come like this. And when it reaches here, the force should change its direction. Now, the field cannot change its direction. Therefore, the current has to change. So here, the force has to change its direction so that it can have a unidirectional torque. Now, in this case, we are not having a unidirectional torque. Here, what is happening is torque reversal is happening. Therefore, here you are having torque reversals. Now, in the next session, I will tell you how does the commutator help us solve this problem? That is, how the commutator overcomes this problem of this torque reversal and gives us a unidirectional torque. All right? So I hope you have understood this lecture. Please wait for the next lecture where I will be clearing the concept of how the DC motor works. So please like, share and subscribe this video if you liked it. So I'll see you in the next lecture. Thank you.